Okay, Neil, we can see you coming down the ladder now.
Okay. I'm at the foot of the ladder. The limb footbeds are only depressed in the surface about 1 or 2 inches. It's almost like a powder.
Armstrong is on the moon. Neil Armstrong, 38-year-old American, standing on the surface of the moon on this July 20th, 1969.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
His quote was, "That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind."
This is the firing launch control of the Apollo missions. This is not a mock-up. These are the very consoles we sat in when men first took off to fly to the moon. The tragedy of Apollo 1 had put us a year and a half behind. We were making up for it in one big leap, and we were doing it with a rocket that no man had ever flown before. It was a few days before Christmas, 1968, when Apollo 8 sat on the pad. She was the first of a new kind, a moon rocket. This was the Phoenix, risen from the ashes of Apollo 1. The first Apollo crew did not die in vain. This was to be their testament. She had been fully fueled throughout the night. The liquid oxygen in her tanks caused ice to form on the outside of the craft. The extreme temperature difference between the air and the sub-zero fuel caused the metal skin of the rocket to expand and contract. Everyone was on the pad agreed. It was as though the rocket was alive, breathing, straining at the leash. Earlier in the morning, astronauts Frank Borman, Jim Lovell, and Bill Anders had made their final preparations before taking that long ride out to the waiting spacecraft. The minimum safe distance from a Saturn V to liftoff was 3 miles. The reason was simple. When fully fueled, the rocket contained the explosive power of an atomic bomb. As the clock counted down, the astronauts, and all of us in launch control, went through the pre-flight checks, our hands on the controls of the most powerful, most complex machine ever built. It had over 2 million separate systems, and to bring these men back alive, everything had to work perfectly. Each individual system had been tested, but what we didn't know was how they would perform when all 2 million began to work together. That moment would come when the countdown clock reached zero. If a maneuvering thruster failed, if communications broke down, if navigation was off by 1 degree, if any piece of the miles of wiring, circuits, relays, or valves was defective, Frank Borman, Jim Lovell, and Bill Anders would pay with their lives. As they sat waiting for launch on that chill December morning, these three astronauts were back to what they had always been, test pilots. You are now in the final minutes before the launch of Apollo 8, right here where it actually happened. Mankind is about to leave his planet behind and journey to another. It is one of those rare moments when history is not being made, destiny is being embraced.
Verify the flight. Verify the flight. Verify the flight. Verify the flight. launch control. T-minus 3 minutes and coming. We've completed our communications checks with the Apollo 8 astronauts in the cabin, and the communications are go. During this period, once we do get the firing command, the various do we have firing command? The firing command is in. We are now on the automatic sequence. 2 minutes, 2 minutes, 20 seconds. Spacecraft ready, final check of the emergency detection system, that ready light also on. First stage preparations are completed.
All systems
are ready, okay, team 59.
We're on, ready to go in front of
me.
And by water. Okay, you're on.
All systems go. T-minus 45 seconds and coming. The first stage of the oxygen tank has been pressurized and the pressure's still building up. Coming up on 90 seconds, mark T-minus 90 seconds and coming. The Apollo 8 crew standing by, Spacecraft Commander Frank Borman, Jim Lover, Bill Anders. We now have a report that the liquid hydrogen tank on the third stage is pressurized. 1 minute, 15 seconds. All three stage propellants pressurized at this time as we come up on the 60-second mark on the flight to the moon. 60 seconds and counting, the vehicle now is completely pressurized. We're coming up on a power transfer shortly. We have the power transfer. We're now on the flight batteries within the launch vehicle. Seconds, all aspects we are still on board at this time. 10, 9, 8, mission sequence.